Our Air Force, all of you, has been ready when our nation called. You are why we have the very best Air Force in the world. In this 40th anniversary year, let us take pride in our heritage and renew our commitment to excellence. Together we can build on the foundation of these early visionaries, and we can make a great Air Force even greater.
Since man first took battle to the skies, the story of air power has been a drama of sacrifice and triumph. Through war and peace, on distant flight lines or in hostile skies, dedicated airmen have risked their lives to fly, to fight, and to win. Aboard his presidential plane, Harry Truman signs the National Security Act of 1947. The act reorganizes the Department of Defense and creates a separate Air Force. With its independence, the United States Air Force sets out to discover the future. October 14, 1947. In the rocket-powered Bell X-1, Captain Chuck Yeager breaks the sound barrier and propels the Air Force into the supersonic age. Engineers developed the XP-59, the direct ancestor of all American jet aircraft. A new technology emerges in the new Air Force. Turbines and combustion chambers begin to replace the once familiar pistons and props. The XP-59 evolves into the F-80 Shooting Star. Faster and more reliable than its predecessor, the Shooting Star is the Air Force's first operational jet fighter. Four jet engines boost the range of the B-36 Peacemaker to over 10,000 miles. The nuclear Air Force now has a truly intercontinental bomber. On June 24, 1948, the Russians blockade Berlin. The city becomes a small island in a sea of hostile Soviet-occupied territory. Air crews and mechanics of the Military Air Transport Service rush to aid the besieged Germans. For 15 months, Berlin is kept alive by airlift. Flying sorties around the clock, American and British crews deliver over 2 million tons of food and supplies. Men push their planes beyond the limit. Loaded transports land every 3 minutes, night and day, rain or shine. Braving the hazardous flight conditions cost the lives of 45 crewmen. Operation Vittles keeps Berlin free from communism. The Russians lift the siege on May 12, 1949. Less than a year after the last American aircraft flies in the Berlin airlift, the communists strike again. On June 25th, 1950, the Air Force begins its first experience in fighting a limited war in a nuclear age. Jet fighter tactics evolve quickly in the unforgiving arena of air-to-air combat. F-86 Sabre pilots shoot down Russian-built MiGs at the rate of 10 to 1. 38 fighter pilots earn the title of ace. 5 victories make Major James Dibara the Air Force's first jet ace, and he finishes the war with 15 confirmed kills. Captain Joseph McConnell tallies 16 victories and is the Air Force's leading ace in Korea. After 3 years of bloody fighting, the conflict ends. North Korea signs the Armistice Agreement on July 27, 1953. In the 1950s, Air Force research launches a revolution in aeronautics. Information gathered by test pilots speeds the development of high-performance aircraft. Test pilot, Lieutenant Colonel Frank Everest, becomes the fastest man alive when he takes the Bell X-2 to almost 3 times the speed of sound. Each of the experimental aircraft answers a question, proves a theory. Together, these experiments bring the Air Force a step closer to the future. B-52 Stratofortress, one offspring of this research, enters service in 1955.
Zero. Operating. We're underway. Roger, reading you loud and clear.
Missile projects receive the highest priority of Air Force programs. The success of the Atlas booster leads to the development of Titan I and the solid propellant intercontinental ballistic missile Minuteman I. At the end of the decade, X-15 pilots explore the fringes of the atmosphere. Major Robert White reaches a record altitude of 50 miles. Pilots prepare the way for astronauts. In 1965, Major Ed White leads the Air Force into space when he steps from his Gemini 4 capsule to become the first American to walk in space.
Roger, I understand our copy. He is outside of the spacecraft at this time. No, we're coming over the left man. We should come back in now.
From the dream of space exploration, the Air Force enters the reality of Vietnam. From the early 60s until 1973, the Air Force fights for the freedom of South Vietnam. The struggle is frustrated by constraints that offset advantages in skill and technology, frustrated by a lack of clear and definable objectives. Hindsight can't obscure the great dedication with which active duty and reserve forces did their jobs in Southeast Asia. Captain Steve Ritchie engages enemy fighters to protect Strike Force aircraft from MiG attacks. Captain Ritchie becomes the first of three Air Force aces in Vietnam.
Quite a bit of shooting down MiGs has been in the right place at the right time, and I've been very lucky to be just in that position on five different occasions. Of course, the thing I'd like to emphasize here is this is probably the greatest team effort of any job that I know of.
But no actions provide a better testimony to the compassion and professionalism of Air Force people than rescues performed by the Aerospace Rescue and Recovery Service. Over 1,200 times they pulled downed airmen to safety.
Okay, we've got smoke.
Right,
Dave. Go get him.
Okay, just stand by, Dave. We're coming in to get you. Stand by.
Okay, Slammer appears to be injured. I'm going to put a PJ on. I'm getting a PJ on up there. I'm going to sit him down.
PJ
down
the door.
Put up with flying daily deep into Vietnam to rescue the downed airmen, that I can speak for every pilot in Southeast Asia when I can say that they're the true heroes of this war.
In 1973, the Air Force brings home its prisoners of war. At last, they return to freedom after years of painful captivity.
Well, we're really receiving the things that I think would be more appropriate they do to the guys that will always be over there, that are buried in the dirt and the mud of North Vietnam and the jungles of South Vietnam also. We're a symbol of the people that were lost. We happen to be regained.
The Vietnam experience leaves a legacy of dedication and courage to the men and women of today's Air Force. Today, active duty, reserve forces, and civilians train to keep the total force strong and ready. Individual efforts combine to meet the nation's defense needs and maintain peace. In one lifetime, air power has grown from fabric-covered biplanes to supersonic jets. But history is ultimately the story of people and what they did with what they had. Technology changes, but the commitment and courage of Air Force men and women remains constant. Tomorrow's Air Force doesn't belong to new aircraft, weapons, or technology. Tomorrow's Air Force belongs to you.